Hello, thanks for checking out a video from the UMass blog for online tools for teaching and learning. This is a video about Netboardme, which is, as they say, a free and easy online tool to collect, organize, and share any web content. When you appear on Netboardme's website, you can either log in or sign up here. If you are a new user, you would sign up and they send you a verification email. I already have an account, so I'm going to log into my account to show you guys quickly what Netboard can do as an educator. Here you see create new Netboard, which is what you will be doing as a teacher. You will be making a new Netboard called whatever you want to call it. You can change it from private to the World Wide Web. You can change the layout here. You can change the skin here. You can change the colors it's already going to appear like and some other options. And then you hit create. Once you create the Netboard, it shows up completely empty, almost like you don't know what to do at this point. But once you get here, you go up to edit and you can post any link into here and it will show up. So if you have a lot of links or a lot of videos you want to share with your students, you can post them here and they will all stay here and be in one nice spot. I want to post the link to our UMass blog here and see what happens. The blog pops up like this. I can edit the text here. I can do lots of things here. So now let's say I was on UMass blogs and I found this awesome tool. This is for Flipgrid and I wanted to post it here too. I can post the link. And now this pops up and I could move this to the bottom, move it to the top. I could lock this position so this one's always there. So as you can see, they were just barely scraping the surface, but this could turn into an entire web page. You can edit things all around the web page. You can edit the text. You can edit the layout of the web page, the skin of the web page to drastically change the colors of the web page. And once you are done, you hit save. And now you can manage access links. You can generate a link like a Google Doc right here, or you can go to set co-authors properties. You can again change it to the private or for the World Wide Web. This is just a brief intro for Netboard, but I hope it taught you a lot about the tool and potentially what you could do for it. The options are really limitless for you as an educator to use this tool, considering you can put anything on a Netboard. Thank you for checking out this video and for checking out the UMass blogs for online tools.